Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Indonesia International Mega Procurement Exhibition and Conference 2019.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ya Allah, kalau kami begitu sibuk, kami lupa ada orang tua yang telah berjasa mendidik dan membesarkan kami dengan bersusah payah mengorban segala-galanya. Ampuni atas kekurangan kami dalam mengabdi berbakti kepadanya, ya Allah.
Thank you for coming and sharing with us on this event your experience and leading practice where we can discuss together with procurement leaders and practitioners from Indonesia. This event is designed in collaboration with LKPP, with IFPSM. Actually, most of the speakers today is part of the association with the International Federation of Purchase and Supply Chains Management.
在宏观层面，采购与供应链已经从单个企业的效益的第三利润源，变为企业社会责任和产业发展的重要抓手，也是许多国家经济安全和发展战略的重要组成部分。Mekanisme
proses pengadaan barang jasa menjadi salah satu tools yang digunakan untuk mendorong tidak hanya pertumbuhan ekonomi. Ke depan kita harapkan bahwa pengadaan ini menjadi fungsi yang sangat strategis untuk memberikan arah dalam perencanaan pembangunan dan penganggaran di pemerintah.
Okay, on my countdown from 3, 2, 1, we will hit the gong together. 3, 2, 1.
Without further delays, I would like to invite our distinguished guest speakers. Can you please come up to the stage to join me? Welcome.
To begin with, I will need to correct the three myths of innovation. Number one, we cannot rock the boat. Number two, we cannot fail. And three, we are too junior to make a difference.
What killed the business? Do you have a guess? It was the procurement people who killed the business. I know this from reliable sources. And why? When you become big, you become also arrogant. They squeezed the last cents from the suppliers. And what happened? The suppliers stopped sharing their innovations, their best knowledge in the business.
Sebastian and Marcus have actually given you significant good insights of what's actually going on. But I actually wanted to also narrow in on how we as procurement professionals could really reap the benefits of these many best practices. And I will be happy to share with you what are we actually doing along the way of advocacy and delivering global solutions.
WIKA is one of the biggest supply chain management and state-owned company in Indonesia. So our portfolio is very big. Our portfolio is very wide. So if I may present to you that because our portfolio is very wide and diversified, so we need some strategy that need to collaborate and integrate to make competitive advantage for the company.
Today we have the afternoon session is human capital development towards future procurement professional.
Well, I bring this this motto, values for value, because I really think that we're speaking about the relation with suppliers, we're speaking about money, we're speaking about what we can get from suppliers, but if we don't have ourselves values, we cannot create value.
Always we need to remember, there are some very, very good things we discussed this morning. Our president, He Liming, talking about 25% cost reduction, and then keep on talking about 30%, yeah, on the time saving. If you still remember, he's talking about 50% on what? on the value.
We all know Mahatma Gandhi. He said, live as if you will die tomorrow. Learn as if you are going to live forever. So he has emphasized the continuous learning and the lifelong learning.
So I believe in Indonesia itself, the halal is well known in Indonesia because Malaysia and Indonesia are the leading country that providing the halal products, halal certification and following by another country.
This is the role of government procurement in Indonesian economy. As we can see here that government spending on public procurement has enormous amount. In terms of gross domestic product, it's about 7%. Maybe this figure is a little bit lower if you compare to other countries. But this is also shows that the quality of spending is becoming more and more important.
Ladies and gentlemen, finally we got to the last session of this Indonesia International Mega Procurement Exhibition and Conference 2019.
国际采购与供应管理联盟 IFPSM 我们亚太区的成员来参加，这次会议开得非常成功。我们可以说，整个印尼的采购界加上我们 IFPSM 亚太区的成员坐在一起来探讨采购与供应链 发展的现状与趋势.
Thank you so much for inviting me to this grand conference in Jakarta. I'm really very excited, and I do see, you know, the energy. I do see the passion coming out from the audience.
I think this is simply excellent, very professional. Whistle emits everything perfect.
I think the whole event is a very clear and transparent manifestation that Indonesia is really going to the right path on improving their procurement.
I think it's fantastic. This is the first time I have seen such a large gathering. You know, I was overwhelming. The inauguration ceremony is over 3,000.
This UN, right?
Yes.
Yeah, fantastic. Really, yeah, I enjoy the environment. And also I interact with the people, and then I see the future.
Kita garis bawahi bahwa kegiatan e-impact ini merupakan bagian yang tidak terpisahkan dari kerja bersama antara asosiasi dengan lembaga kebijakan pengadaan barang dan jasa pemerintah, dan ini adalah pertemuan internasional sehingga konferensinya pun narasumbernya juga dari pihak-pihak luar yang sharing knowledge, sharing pengalaman, dan pamerannya pun cukup beragam. Produk-produk yang disajikan mulai dari produk rumah tangga sampai produk yang mempunyai teknologi tingkat tinggi. Jadi harapannya masyarakat yang hadir, baik semua pelaku pengadaan maupun masyarakat biasa, dapat melihat bahwa pemerintah bekerja sama dengan asosiasi melakukan acara e-impact ini ingin memberikan yang terbaik buat negeri ini.